This is a Throwback Thursday we hope not to do here on WGN News Now, but on Tuesday it happened. Major League Baseball canceled games for the first time in 27 years due to a work stoppage. It brings back memories of the 1994-1995 players' strike, and we look back at the beginning of that in this week's edition of Throwback Thursday.
The White Sox were not only poised for a second straight division title, this time coming in the brand new AL Central, but maybe even a World Series championship, which at that point they'd not won in 77 years. After a win over the Athletics in Oakland on August 10th, they were 67-46 and in first place in the Central. But the next day, they were at Comiskey Park, preparing for a strike, yet still hoping for the best, including eventual MVP Frank Thomas.
In first place at this junction, so you know there's hope everyone's optimistic about us coming back because we're going to come back sooner or later.
Well, that didn't happen for the White Sox, and neither for the Cubs, who were in the midst of a lost season. Their 5-2 loss to the Giants at Wrigley Field on August 10th dropped them to last in the NL Central at 49-64. The late Rod Beck struck out Mark Grace to end the game, and as it turns out, the Cubs' season, which at that moment was significant for the first baseman, since he was a free agent the next year, and his future in Chicago was very much in question.
It's an unfortunate way to walk out, and as I was walking off after I struck out there, you know, I kind of just took a look around, and this could be the last time I'd wear 17 with the pinstripe.
Now, Grace would end up staying with the Cubs and would play with them through 2000, and that includes the 1995 season, which did finally get started toward the end of April, after the strike ended a few weeks earlier. As for the White Sox, it was the closing of a window. The team would not return to the playoffs until 2000, with mostly new members of the team than the one they had in 1994. Larry Hawley, WGN News Now.